Good morning, City family. Can I just get you guys to rise today as we praise Jesus this morning? All right, let's go.
And I searched the world, but it couldn't fill me. Man's empty praise, treasures that fade are never enough. Then you came along and put me back together, and every desire is now satisfied here in your love. Oh, there's nothing better than you. There's nothing better than you. There's nothing, nothing. To show you my weakness, my failures and flaws, you see them all, still call me friend. 'Cause the God of the mountain is the God of the valley. Your mercy and grace won't find me again.
magnify your name, Lord. We bring to you a sacrifice of praise.
Jesus, Jesus, precious Lord, none on the earth nor heavens above that I have found more beautiful. You are my treasure, my great reward, and I just want to move your heart. It's all I want to do. I just want to stand in awe and pour my love on you, no matter how much the cost. I freely give it all to you.
Pour my oil out. Is it
all I want to do. I just want to stand in awe and pour my love on you, no matter how much the cost. Freely give it all to you, and all to you. I just want to move your heart, caught within your gaze, right here in your presence, Lord, is where I want to stay. Oh, just to dwell in your house, waste my hours and my days on you, on you, Jesus. Give you praise forevermore. We're made for love. So sing out your own song, sing out your heart's cry. It's putting a song of love in your heart, song of praise in your heart. Sing it out, sing it out. Lift it up, lift it up. Sing it out, sing it out. We love you, we love you. You were made for love. We were made to praise you, to adore you.
Find strength in your presence. cry with my head lifted high and my spirit revived in your story. I look to the cross as my failure is lost in the light of your glorious grace. Let the ruins come to life in the beauty of your name, rising up from the ashes. Now forever you reign, and my soul will find a refuge in the shadow of your wings. I will love you forever and forever I'll sing. Let the ruins come to life in the beauty of your name, rising up from the ashes. God, forever you reign, and my soul will find a refuge in the shadow of your wings.
of your name. Sing up from the ashes, forever you reign. So we'll find a refuge, shadow of your wings. I will love you forever, forever I see.
Jesus, this is your gospel. That what was once dead can now be made alive again. Your word tells us that the same spirit that rose you from the grave is the same spirit that is at work in us today. That same spirit that breathes life into our mortal beings. That same spirit that takes us from a place where we were once dead in our sin and our trespasses, and today we are made alive to you in your kingdom and in your grace. That same spirit that takes us, a people who were once orphans, alienated from your presence, to ones who are called sons and daughters who belong to your kingdom. God, this is your gospel. Jesus, this is the gospel to which you proclaimed 2,000 years ago, and this is the gospel to which we proclaim today, that ruins can indeed come to life in the beauty of the name of Jesus. That name which is above all other names. That name where we proclaim sickness vows, disease vows, that name to which all men are saved, that name to which we cling on to, our hope, the hope of salvation. Jesus, this is your gospel. And today, your people, we celebrate life, life that only comes in Jesus' name. Lord, we thank you for your gospel and we rejoice in it this morning. You know, friends, you know, this morning we are going to spend some time partaking in Holy Communion and invite you wherever you're at. You know, if you're at home and you do not have the elements ready, I would just love to give you some time to get it ready. And this is not just a ritual that we participate in. It's not just a thing that we do once a month, but it is sacred. It is a sacred tradition and practice to which we've inherited. We see this in the words of Scripture, that all who profess to be followers of Jesus would remember Christ, His gospel, His sacrifice on the cross through the elements. This is a sacred time. And so when you have the elements ready, I would love to read a passage of Scripture to help frame this time to which we're about to partake in together. 1 Corinthians 11. Now we are big fans of verse 23 to 26 that tells us about Jesus' sacrifice on the cross, how He shed His blood, how His body was broken for our sake. And this is wonderful news, that we who are unworthy, sinful people, that were once dead in our sins, in our trespasses, today we are made alive through Jesus. Today we belong in His kingdom. We are sons and daughters, folks. This is what the cross has accomplished for us. But in verse 27 of that same chapter, it says this in God's word: therefore, whoever eats this bread or drinks this cup of the Lord in an unworthy manner will be guilty of the body and blood of the Lord. But let a man examine himself, and so let him eat of the bread and drink of the cup. For he who eats and drinks in an unworthy manner eats and drinks judgment to himself, not discerning the Lord's body. For this reason, many are weak and sick among you, and many sleep. Now, there's a lot that we can go through in this text, but I would just like to point out something. You know, one of the ways that this text has been read is this: if I, you know, consider myself unworthy, if I consider myself sinful, if I consider myself, just not feeling all that spiritual and right with God, then I should just refrain from taking this because I'm unworthy and I need to go and sort myself out. I need to go and fix myself and get myself right and in order before I can partake of this sacred elements. Now that completely goes against what the rest of the text says earlier. It completely goes against what the gospel is about. The gospel isn't about us through our own works and self-effort being made right before God. The gospel is this: that man recognizes his or her sinfulness, wretchedness, and complete need for God, his blood, his body, to make us right. And we receive it with whole hearts. And this is what we ought to do every time we partake of the elements. Do not do so in a haphazard way. Do not do so with a kind of thought that if I'm not right, then I shouldn't take it. But we ought to do what this text has instructed us to do. We ought to take a moment, examine ourselves. The word there would mean to consider ourselves. Consider ourselves in light of what? In light of all that we've read earlier. What Christ has accomplished for us through the cross. And the text doesn't say, examine yourself, and if you know you're not feeling it, then don't take it. It says, examine yourself, and so let them eat and drink of the blood and of the body. And so, you know, let's just take a moment. Examine ourselves. I invite you wherever you're at, with eyes closed and head bowed. Examine yourself first of all. Where you're at today. Examine yourself for where you've gone astray, where you have wandered off into a path that God has not intended for you to. Examine yourself, the interactions you've had with people. Examine yourself, your heart. Has it grown cold? Is it apathetic? Examine yourself. And thank God that we don't just stop here. Thank God that He gives us His grace, His gospel. And so in light of all that you have just reflected on, consider now the work of Calvary. Consider now the work of Jesus. Consider now what He says over you. Consider now how He's accepted you and pulled you into His kingdom, out of darkness into His marvelous light. God, we thank You for Your gospel. We thank You for Your grace that is so sufficient for us. Even in this moment, as we're confronted with all our weakness and all our failings, we consider how Your mercy triumphs, how Your mercy supersedes and overwhelms all of the failings in our lives. We thank You for Your grace. We thank You for Your gospel. And so with that in mind, in our heart, that we partake of the elements this morning, I invite you right now to pick up the bread. Says this in God's word, that the Lord Jesus, on the same night in which He was betrayed, took bread, and when He had given thanks, He broke it, and then He said this, "Take, eat, this is My body, which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of Me." Let us all partake of the bread this morning. The word says this as well. In the same manner, He also took the cup after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in My blood. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of Me." Let's partake of the cup this morning. Thank You, Lord. Lord, we thank You for Your body and Your blood. Lord, we look to the cross this morning. We say, You, O God, are sufficient. Your grace is sufficient for our weakness and our failings. And Jesus, we cling on to Your words of promise. We cling on to the work of Calvary. We cling on to Your mighty name, O God. And Lord, this day we repent from dead works. We repent of sinful desires. And God, we looked to Your cross this morning. We thank You for this day. We thank You for all that You're doing, even in this moment. We believe that something profound is happening in our hearts, in our bodies this day. Lord, we thank You for this great divine exchange. Death for life. Life and life and life, abundant life in Jesus' name. Thank You for all these things. And all of God's people say, amen, amen. Come on, let's lift up a shout of praise to the Lord. Worthy Jesus, deserving of our praise. Come on, wherever you are, in your homes, in your living rooms, your bedrooms,